is like love, love, love and music. Hello, everyone. Thank you for tuning in. I am Jay Lee. This is Jay Lee's Corner. I am out and about on Sunday, okay? It is Sunday. So, no lipstick. You know what I'm saying? Hoodie on. My hoodie, the mind, the business that pays you hoodie is finally well, cold enough to wear it outside. And, oh my God, y'all don't like to be acting stupid. Anyway, if you have not done so already, please take a moment to subscribe to my channel, and then also hit the notification bell so that it lets you know when I have new videos up. Now, y'all see from the title of this video, what is it about, what it's about. I heard the story of this shooting, I think the day it happened, because I kept seeing it on, like, people's news feeds and stuff like that, and I was trying to wait to see, like, more information about what actually transpired, because when I first heard it, I was confused, like, how do you accidentally shoot and kill someone thinking that they're in your apartment? Like, I didn't understand how that happened. So the young man's name, and I hope I'm not mispronouncing his name, it looks like it's pronounced both of them either Jean or Jean. And he was a young man in his own apartment, an off-duty police officer, a white woman. Okay, let's make that clear. A white woman killed him. As she said, her story is she mistook his apartment for hers, and when he answered the door of his apartment, she shot him dead. This is what kind of pisses me off a lot when we have situations like this. It's a couple different things I do not understand, okay? For one, how do you not realize your key don't work, so that can't be your place? Like, they said already that, you know, that she tried her key, allegedly, and her key did not work. If your key doesn't work, it ain't your apartment. Okay? If your key does not work, it is not your apartment. Now, we don't know, or I don't know, if she was knocking on the door and that's why he opened the door, or if he heard, you know, because, of course, he dead. You know what I'm saying? So we don't have any of his, you know, his story about what actually happened. You know, all we know is what she said, because she's the only living person, because she shot this black man dead in his own goddamn apartment. So I kept wondering when I first heard the story. I was like, well, when her key wasn't working, like, did she start knocking on the door? Because to me, that does not make any sense. Because if you, like, does she live alone? Okay, because if she lives alone and she gets to her place and her key don't work, why would you knock on your own door? Because who in the house? You know what I'm saying? So I had those kind of, so I was waiting to say something so I kind of heard more things, but I haven't heard more than what the initial story was, which was that she was home, came home after getting off shift, and, you know, her key didn't work. He, for some reason, opened the door. And when he opened the door, she assumed that he was in her apartment, and she shot him dead. And the reason I have an issue with that is, why you, I mean, like, what did he do that made you want to shoot him dead? Like, I don't get that. And it's like, if someone opens the door, like, a thief don't open the door. You know what I'm saying? Like, that does not happen. So I feel like you didn't think that he was, like, breaking in. And he was in your apartment. He broke in. So you got to kill. It's nothing in my mind that can explain why she shot him dead. Like, I tried to kind of, like, what, you know, was it a scuffle? Did he lunge at her? Like, I'm like, what was the reason that you would shoot someone dead? Like, and again, your key did not work. So so that's not your apartment. So I did see, I saw someone posted a video online earlier today. It was someone else who lives in that same complex. And it was a video showing how their keys work. And in that particular complex, the video showed, you know, each key works only for the person, the apartment who was for. And when you put your key in your door, the lock chain is like a different color. So like if it's your apartment, when your key goes in, it turns, okay? It turns and it turns green. If you're not at your apartment, when you put your key in, the key don't even turn. So it's like if you live there, you know how your doors work. You know what I'm saying? You know that if you put your key in, it won't turn if that ain't your apartment. So it's the weird thing of how did she not know it was not her apartment? She was also on the wrong floor. Was you drunk? Were you high? You had no, was it, it had to be a different apartment number. You know what I'm saying? Because no apartment in the same complex has the same apartment number, okay? There's only one 205 in that particular building, I'm assuming, because my thing is 205 is for the fucking second floor, okay? You can't be in apartment 315 and you go up to apartment 215 and assume it's yours. It's two different numbers, okay? The apartments on different floors won't have the same number. So again, like, to me, it just, nothing makes sense of her story of, oh, I mistakenly went to the wrong apartment and I ended up killing him dead. No, it's a whole bunch of foul play, if you ask me, to the situation. We do know that the chief of the police had initially issued a warrant for the girl's arrest for the crime, but they let, like, either the feds or something, who was it? Because it was the Dallas police. They let somebody else come in to take over the case because it's an officer-involved shooting. So that department of whatever decided to hold off on issuing a warrant while they still investigate. Investigate what? What can you investigate, okay? There's only one person's story because she killed the other person. But my thing is, again, why do cops, and we saw the mom, she did a little interview, whatever, you know, talking about how sad she is and stuff, and how she wonders if her son wasn't black, if the cop would have shot to kill. Again, why did she shoot to kill? And I'm like, who? And that's your neighbor. Like, y'all live in the same building. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, did you know him, lady? Like, what was going on? I feel like more is going to come out about the situation, but it's so unfortunate that this keeps happening where it happens to be a black person being killed by a white cop. And the crazy part is we then have to only rely on the white cop's perspective of what happened because they killed the other person. It's so crazy, okay? And he was in his own apartment, minding his own business, okay? He wasn't fucking with nobody. He was at home chilling, and she came and killed that man in his own place, okay? It makes you think of not wanting to fucking open your own door when you at home because it can be a crazy ass cop trying to kill you for no apparent fucking reason. So, you know, it's just very, it made me really, really upset because, you know, I live in an apartment too, but I don't ever open my door for anybody, okay? If you're knocking, you have to announce yourself, but I'm assuming that maybe he heard someone at his door, or maybe she, because someone else said they heard the girl screaming for him to open the door as if they knew each other. So, but again, I don't know if that's true, but someone did say that. But I saw the video that a girl posted who lived at the apartment. Her video showed the cop right after the shooting, and she looked all frazzled. She's on the phone, and the girl was saying how this was like right after the shooting happened, and she was recording from like one level down. And you do see the cop in her uniform all looking frazzled or whatever. And then the second video this girl had, you see them taking his body out on a stretcher, and you see the EMTs working on him, like, you know what I'm saying, doing CPR or whatever, because he was pronounced dead at the hospital. So you see all of this on this girl IG who lives in the apartment because she heard the gunshots. So she went and she said, yeah, you know, the cop was out there, you know, crying or whatever for a few minutes, and just pacing back and forth. So she didn't get a video of that. So it just makes me wonder, girl, what happened? Okay, what happened and why did you kill this man? And then it was also said that this is not her first time shooting someone and killing them. And the first time she did it, she got, like, she didn't get charged. Her ass need to get charged this time, because it ain't no way on God's green earth that that cop went to the wrong apartment, assumed it was hers, and then someone opened the door and then she killed them. That just don't sound right, okay? That sound like some shit she came up with as she was killing him, okay? And that's all. So I'm gonna leave it there. You know what I'm saying? Y'all put y'all comments below. Again, rest in peace to this young man who lost his life, you know what I'm saying, based on someone killing him. That's basically what it was. She killed him. And I don't care what nobody say. So I'm gonna leave it at that, y'all. Peace.